Today I'll be showing you guys how to wire up your own transistor flip-flop, which I have here on my breadboard, as you can see. And I'll try to explain in as much detail as I can as to how it works and how to pick out the resistor values and all the other little details so you can basically build this thing on your own without having to look up a schematic for it. And this is probably going to be a long tutorial in two or three parts because I'm going to explain the other states that you can connect this thing in and what cool things you can do with it. And at the end of this video, I'm going to show you a circuit that I built using a flip-flop and show you what it does and how you can basically use flip-flops. If you're watching this video, I assume that you know how transistors work and how to connect them. So nevertheless, I want to show you some basic concepts that are important to understanding how this flip-flop works. So we'll start with the obvious voltage dividers. And when we have two resistors connected in series, the point in between them, the output, is going to be equal to the ratio of the resistors calculated by this formula. As you can see here, this is 0.81. Now, what we have here is basically a voltage divider. What a transistor is a variable resistor, all right? More precisely, a current-controlled variable resistor. Now, when the transistor is off, then the resistance between the collector and emitter is very high, in the order of a few tens of mega ohms. So when we have 1 kilo ohm and a few mega ohms, then you can see the output is going to be almost a plus voltage. We call this collector high, all right? And when the transistor is fully on or saturated, then the resistance is going to be between the collector and the emitter is going to be very small, like in the order of a few ohms, maybe even less than one ohm. So you can see here, if you have 1K and 1 ohm, then the output is going to be almost at ground, all right? So, and the collector is going to be almost the ground, and we call this collector low. So, transistor on, collector low, transistor off, collector high. Right, good so far. Now, let's go back to our flip-flop. This arrangement is called the bistable flip-flop, and this is what I have here connected at the moment. And you can see here it has two stable states. This state where it stays is gonna stay like this until I do something to it. Now I can't do something to it and change the state, and it's gonna stay here until I do something again. Basically, what we have here is this is the one circuit and this is the other part, and it's fully symmetrical in the middle. So a practical approach to how this works: when we power this up, it's gonna start in one of these two states. Let's say it starts in the set state. Okay, so this means that this transistor Q1 is fully on, and current flows through from here to here, powering up the LED, so we can see what state it's in. And the important thing is here: transistor on, collector low, right? And you can see here the collector of the Q1 is connected through a resistor to the base of Q2, and the collector of Q2 is connected through a resistor to the base of Q1. So when this transistor is on, this transistor is fully off, because you can see that this collector is low, which means that there's no base voltage to turn this on. So this is off, the collector is high, and when the collector is high, then this applies a good, through this resistor, supplies a good current to the first base, which turns the transistor on. Now, when I come and push this switch, which is this switch here, the reset, then what happens is that I supply a burst of current to the base of Q2. Now what happens is that this transistor turns on momentarily, and that's enough, right? This transistor turns on, and the collector goes low for a moment. When the collector goes low, then you can see that less current is supplied to the base of Q1, which means that the transistor starts shutting down. Then the collector starts going high, and when the collector goes high, starts going high, then we can see that more current is going to be supplied to this base, which turns this transistor even on even more. And when it turns even more, then the collector goes even higher, which means less current here. And you can basically see that this is a feedback loop in which one, when I push the switch, one of the transistor automatically pulls the other one up and the other one pushes the other one down. All right. This is basically how the bistable flip-flop works. It's really simple. I suggest you build this this thing using this schematic and try out different values for the resistors, and you will understand them much better. All right. Concerning the values of the resistors, here anything from 1k to 10k works, and try to keep these resistors the same. If they're slightly off, then it doesn't matter, it will still work. And the base, the collector resistances can be anything from 10k to 200k, works fine, I don't know, works for me. Try on your own, try values and different values and see what works. Now, there are a lot of different cool things that you can do with it just by changing a few components here, and I'll be showing you guys two more states in which you can connect this guy, right? So before we do that though, what I want to do is I want to take these LEDs out of the circuit, so they basically don't interfere with the set and the reset. And what I did here is this part is exactly the same, except I took out the LEDs, and the collectors of both of the transistors are connected to PNP transistors. Basically, when one of the, when let's say the reset's active, then the collector is low, which switches on this transistor and the LED, you know, glows. The reason why I did this is so I can keep the 1K values and the LED glows bright, and I can play around with these values. What I have here in this on the breadboard right now is I have connected like this, and you will see the point in a bit when I'm gonna try to show, when I'm gonna be showing you the rest of the stuff that you can do with the flip-flop.